In this video, we'll learn about the formatting. Now suppose if you have some data in your Tableau and you want to just format the data based on the font, the title, the caption, the shadings, the borders, anything. So it can be done with the help of formatting. Let us see that. The very first one which we'll be working is with related to font, and the next video series will show you how to work on alignment, shading, borders and so on. I'm working in the file named as formatting, and the data which I have is Global Superstore 2017. Now I'll try to create some data here and I'll try to change the font of those data. So first of all, I'll try to bring here as market in the columns. Second is I'll just bring here as subcategory in the rows. And third one, I'll pick up the sales and put into the text. So this is a data where I can find out the sales of the subcategories based on the market. So sales of the subcategories based according to the market areas. Now, if I want to change the font of this, there are various methods you can do. The very first method is I can just go to this format menu bar and I can select this option as font. So if I click on this font, on the left hand side, if you see there's format font and I have this sheet, rows and columns. The very first one, it says nothing but it says as font. And the second one, if I keep my cursor, it says as alignment. Third one, it says as shading. Fourth one as borders. Fifth one as lines. So right now I'm working on this format font and these are the options which are given. So let us see the options. So what are those one by one? This is the font which I want to change here. So for the worksheet, if I click on this drop down, for the entire worksheet, if you want to change something, let's say if I click on this black, or if I click on this, if I change the size as 15, and if you observe here, size of my data has changed to 14-15. I'll make it as bold, italic, underline, and if I keep on changing, the font itself changes here. So if I click outside, same way, if you see here, whatever changes I've made, those area will become as bold. So if I try to change this as headers, if I change it to as red color from here, if you see here, these are the headers, these are the headers. So whatever options I change, that will become into a bold. This one is bold. If you do not want the formatting, if you don't want the formatting here, you can just click on this clear button and the formatting will go away. So it's that easy to change the fonts here. So the first one is, if I try to change the size, if I change the size, everything will change here. Second one is about the pane. What exactly is the pane? I'll try to make it into yellow color. So whatever the area is changing, apart from this headers, row headers and column headers, that is nothing known as panes. So I'll just click on this red color, yellow color. Suppose the colors you inside this are not what you're looking for. You want to change the colors. You can click on this more colors. You can choose the colors from here. Let's say if I choose here from green color, or if I choose this dark green color, click on OK. So that is now a dark green color itself, right? If you want to change the font text, you can just change the font from here. Let's say if I select here as my favorite, that is Bookman old style. That is nothing but a Bookman old style, which is given here. So worksheet, the second one is pane and the third one is headers. So if I want to change the headers into red color, if you see, these are the headers which are given, the column headers and the row headers. If I want to change the tooltip, now what exactly is a tooltip here? If I keep my cursor at any place, this is a tooltip which is given here. If I want to change the tooltip font, I'll click on this tooltip, select here as yellow color. So if I select this as yellow color, now if I keep my cursor at any place, if you observe the text which is given here, it has changed the color into yellow. If I select as red color, and if I keep my cursor here, and if you observe, that is nothing but a tooltip which the color has changed into red color itself. The next one which I have, the title. This is the title which is given here. By default, the title will be taken from your sheet name. So this is nothing but a title which is a sheet name. And if I click on this drop down, I can select the title as green color. The font has become as green itself. Same way, if you want to make it as bold, italic, underline, all these options will be given at this place, right? The next part which I have, this is about the formatting. If you keep on observing, it has changing to into bold itself, whatever changes you have made. Next, which I have is nothing but totals and grand totals. So if you want to see what is total and grand total thing, you need to have some totals at this place. If you want to bring totals, go to the analysis menu bar, click on this totals, and if you see, there are two first options, show rows grand total, show columns grand total. So these are nothing but the rows grand total if you see, and second one, analysis totals, and if I click on this show column grand totals, these are the totals which I've got. Now if you want to change the color of your totals, how it can be done from these two areas itself. Let's see, right now it says it is in the green color. If I click on this place drop down, select this yellow color, and if you see the total has changed to yellow color, the total has been changed to this yellow color itself, right? Same way, if you want to change the headers of your totals, this is your headers of your total. If I select yellow color, if I select as yellow color, if you see that's a total headers, same way the total headers also would be changed at this place. And the grand total also says the same thing. But the only difference you'll find out when you have the nested rows itself, subcategory and category, then it will show you the nested totals and grand totals difference there. So right now what we are working is, we are working with format font, right? So if I click on this drop down, it says market, then I have the subcategory and sales. What are those three things? These are names of the pills which you have: market, subcategory and the sales. Market, subcategory and the sales. So now if you want to be very, very specific about any pill you want to format, you just need to select this option, let's say market. So now if you see, it has changed to format market. If I select format subcategory, if I select format sum of sales. Now if you want to format sum of sales, it says what color do you want? If I say I want this yellow color, this is nothing but sales. If you want to format this one, you have to select as format subcategory. Click on this drop down subcategory, and if this is shown as format subcategory, if I select as green color, if you observe, it has changed to green color itself. So this is how you can keep on changing. So I've shown you just one method how you can format. You can just go to this format menu bar and you can click on this font option. Now this was the method you can bring. If you want to remove this, you can just simply click on this cross button itself and it will go away. Yeah, so now this was one method, and if you want to clear all the formatting at one go, you can just simply click on this drop down at this place where there's a cross sign in the toolbar, and there's option given as clear worksheet formatting. So if you clear everything in the formatting, will be cleared and you'll be getting a blank detail itself. So you don't have to worry about it. It's very simple and easy. This was one method. The second method is, if you want to format anything, let's say subcategory or the market, or you can say as the sales, simply right click on that place like this, and you'll get the option as format. You see there's a format option. You click on format, you'll get format font. If you click on this, right click on this accessories, and if you click on this format, you'll be getting as format subcategory. So wherever you click, if wherever you right click, you'll be getting a dialog box related to that option. If you right click on this market, any option, format, and if you see there's an option given as format market, and if you click on this drop down, is the same thing which you have got it, right? So I hope you're able to understand how do we work with the formatting, especially with the font part. In the next video, I'll show you how to work with the alignments. That's all for this video.